Neurogenesis, Wikipedia article audio. Neurogenesis is the process by which nervous system cells, known as neurons, are produced by neural stem cells. Neural stem cells have the potential to produce many different types of neuron. They include neuroepithelial cells, stem cells, radial glial cells, basal progenitors, subventricular zone astrocytes, and subgranular zone radial astrocytes, among others. Neurogenesis is most active during embryonic development, but continues throughout adult life. Prenatal neurogenesis. Postnatal neurogenesis. Neurogenesis begins during embryogenesis in all animals and is responsible for producing all the neurons of the organism. Prior to the period of neurogenesis, neural stem cells first multiply. The primary neural stem cell of the mammalian brain, called a radial glial cell, resides in the embryonic ventricular zone, which lies adjacent to the developing brain ventricles. The process of neurogenesis then involves a final cell division of the parent neural stem cell, which produces daughter neurons that will never divide again. Most neurons of the human central nervous system live the lifetime of the individual. The molecular and genetic factors influencing neurogenesis notably include the Notch signaling pathway, and many genes have been linked to Notch pathway regulation. In mammals, adult neurogenesis has been shown to occur in two primary regions in the brain, the dentate gyrus of the hippocampus and the subventricular zone. In some mammals, such as rodents, the olfactory bulb is a zone which features integration of adult-born neurons, which migrate from the SVZ through the rostral migratory stream. In some vertebrates, regenerative neurogenesis has also been shown to occur. Many environmental factors, such as exercise, stress, and antidepressants, have been shown to change the rate of neurogenesis within the hippocampus. Neurogenesis during embryonic development takes place in three stages. First, neuroepithelial stem cells produce neurons in the neural tube, that later becomes the brain and spinal cord. After the neural tube closes, neural stem cells operate in the ventricular zone, and radial glial cells replace neuroepithelial cells as the primary producers of new neurons. As embryonic development draws to a close, the ventricular zone finishes developing into the ventricular system of the brain, where the cerebrospinal fluid that surrounds and protects the brain is produced. Neural stem cells called basal progenitors form the tissue that makes up the subventricular zone. After embryonic brain development, neural stem cells reside primarily in the subventricular zone and in another area called the subgranular zone of the dentate gyrus of the hippocampus, and will continue to do so during adulthood. Postnatally, neurogenesis occurs in response to signals coming from either inside or outside of the body instead of occurring automatically as it does in prenatal development. The primary neural stem cells in adulthood are subventricular zone astrocytes and subgranular zone radial astrocytes rather than radial glial cells. Most of these adult neural stem cells lie dormant in the subventricular zone or the subgranular zone. In response to signals, dormant cells, or B cells, produce proliferating cells, or C cells. The C cells then produce the neuroblasts, or A cells, that will become neurons. Adult neurogenesis often serves one of a small number of purposes. For example, neuroblasts might travel via the rostral migratory stream to the olfactory bulb, the region containing cells that detect smell. The neuroblasts in the olfactory bulb become interneurons that help the brain communicate with these sensory cells. The majority of those interneurons are inhibitory granule cells, but a small number are periglomerular cells. Neuroblasts might also migrate to the hippocampus and mature into dentate granule cells. Significant neurogenesis also occurs after birth in the hippocampus. The hippocampus plays a crucial role in the formation of new declarative memories, and it has been theorized that the reason infants cannot form declarative memories because they are still undergoing extensive neurogenesis in the hippocampus. Previous cognitive research suggested that infants could not form declarative memories because of their lack of language skills, but the fact that analogs to this infantile amnesia can be observed in non-human mammals indicates that a lack of language does not account for the entire phenomenon. Significant neurogenesis also occurs in the hippocampus just after birth, and much of adult neurogenesis occurs in the dentate gyrus of the hippocampus as well.